Hi, welcome to yet another episode on Career Growth. Hope you are doing well and finding our Career Growth channel very informative. Up till now, you have seen a lot of episodes on the entrance exams. You have seen episodes about how to choose a country and most of the topics that require for studying abroad that a student looks forward for. So today I'll be talking about is the documentation, which is the most important part of the study abroad application process. When I say documentation, why I'm saying it's very important is because it is little different than what you are currently used to in your Indian systems of education. Like while you have applied for your undergraduate college or you're looking forward for your master's. So when I talk about study abroad, the documentation process is completely different as compared to what you all have seen. Documentation will include a statement of purpose, a personal statement, a resume, your academic records, extracurricular activities, your financial documents, letters of recommendation. All these things put together becomes your documentation for your applications for various universities in various countries. Statement of purpose. When I talk about statement of purpose, it is also called as personal statement, and statement of purpose is commonly known as SOP. Along with SOP, you also need to write certain essays which are required by the universities. The purpose of statement of purpose or personal statement or essays is it talks about your achievements, your academic records, your interest towards this course, and it's all about yourself. So it highlights you as a student, and which is a very important document for the university admissions committee to select you on the basis of the details provided by you. Along with statement of purpose, you also need to produce essays. I mean, you have to submit essays to the universities. Each university will have different kind of questions for your essays. Now, what I mean by essays is there could be a word limit, there could be any abstract topic given to you, or it could be a topic of your choice that you can choose to write these essays. There is a lot of specification in terms of the word limit, the character limit, the way you have to submit the essays. So I'm sure you all are very familiar with the technology, the formats that needs to be used. So do your research well, understand the university's requirements so that it is easy for you to get the perfect essays for yourself. Along with SOP essays, the other important document is going to be your resume. I'm sure you all have heard about the resume word, or even biodata, what typically people call it as. But the resume means you have to highlight your academic details, your achievements, your award wins, your extracurricular activities, any kind of internships done, projects done, work experience. So all these things put together, you have to highlight in a resume. So in short, the admission officer would know what all you have done up till now, be it for your undergraduate studies or as well as for your postgraduate studies. Along with these three, the other important documents for you is going to be your academic documents. Academic document means your mark sheets. Suppose you're applying for your bachelor's program, the university would need you to submit your 10th, 11th standard and 12th standard predictive grades. In case if you're looking for a master's program, then you have to provide your mark sheets up till your bachelor's. Along with the mark sheets, you also need to submit your transcripts, which is in crisp the number of hours of study you have done, and as well as the marks that you have obtained, the minimum, maximum. Each college or each educational institute will have their specific formats for the mark sheets and the transcripts. But provided it should be in English, if there is any other language in your mark sheets or transcripts, make sure they are converted and supported with an English document, because the universities abroad would need all your documentation in English itself. So this is also a very important thing that one has to keep in mind while you're doing your applications abroad. Along with all these documents that I have told you up till now, there's something important which is called as letters of recommendation. Letters of recommendation, even it's commonly known as LOR. Now, you have to get these letters of recommendations either from your teachers, your professors, or any of your seniors from your workplace. The reason that we need the letters of recommendation is, it's the university would want to know you as a student from an outsider. Maybe when I'm saying is a professor or the teacher who have taught you certain subjects, who knows you well and who can give you answers with honesty and objectivity about yourself. So this is also very important, and it has to be in different format. Like one university may ask you, your professors or your teachers, to submit it online, and some may want you to submit it offline, like on a hard copy document on your college or school letterhead. So you have to keep this in mind. So when you're doing your research for the university documentation, please make sure you understand the right format required for the letters of recommendation and do the needful accordingly. We come across many students who come and tell us, ma'am, how do I add value to my resume? How do I do something different? How can I be a better student? Or how can I have my application get successful to the universities which I'm dreaming about? So that's why it comes into the picture, the extracurricular activities. I'm sure you all have heard about extracurricular activities. Extracurricular activities can be anything, right from sports, it can be music, it can be dance, it can be theater, it can be academic achievements. So we always recommend students that you should make sure that you participate in lots and lots of extracurricular activities. It could be even voluntary work for the NGOs. All these things which can add additional value to your resume apart from your academic achievements that you all have been doing right now. So extracurricular activities is also something that you should keep in mind parallelly to your academics. For parents and students, the most important concern is about the budget, the finance that is required for studying abroad, be it any country. So we always tell students that do your research well, understand the budgets required for studies irrespective of the country that you are planning to study in. When we talk about budgets, most of the universities may require you to submit your financial documents while you are doing your applications, and some may need it after you have got an offer letter. So depending on the country, depending on the university, you may also have to keep your financial documents ready while you are preparing for the other documentation for your applications for universities abroad. So when I talk about financial documents, it is basically the sponsors. Like if your parents are going to help you sponsor for your studies, if you're going to take a bank loan or any other resource or the funds that you're going to show for your studies, it's very important that you keep that also ready. So when I'm talking about documentation, it starts from right from the university's requirements. It can be general, it can be specific, university to university. So please do your research well. Understand your budgets, understand the university's requirement, the specific requirements for each course, each application at different levels of your courses, be it undergraduate or be it postgraduate. I hope you have liked the content of today's video. Do not forget to subscribe and like us on our channel, Career Growth.